Live, I said. Where's the eight? Steam is being dumb. Oh, Monster Hunter required. Oh, energy required an update. F1 2020. Da-da-da-da. Where is it? Where's my chat? Oh, there it is. Fantastic. Fine. Wow. We should probably get the... Buttons. Keyboard, get out of the way. So we were going to look at practice 2 really quick to get warmed up here. We've increased the difficulty yet again. But what we were going to look at with car setup... Okay, so we have a really high off-throttle set for this track, and I don't think we touched... We didn't touch any of this.
Okay, let's talk about this track. You can carry much, much more speed through turns 7, 8, and 9 than you might expect.
Get a turn into 7 right,
and you can really find a good rhythm through this section.
So let's,
it's just
try
a slight lift going into the right hander at 9. As for how much, that's a question of bravery.
Shut up, Jeff.
Be alert in case you dip a wheel into the gravel on the exit.
Actually, giving useful advice.
Give us some consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into the race strategy.
So what we're just looking for is more stability, putting the power down. So we're hoping that it's... I can already feel the answer here for us. We just don't want to have any spin-outs during the race. We'd like to go without any flashbacks if we can avoid it. So we'll get some research points here and just see how a lower anti-roll bar feels on a car that should be trimmed out to a basic quality. Get a few laps in the building mode as well. Death Stranding. Now, the car didn't spin out doing that, so that's good. That's good news. That's a really interesting... You saying it's the best you've ever played. Very interesting. It felt so overrated when it came out.
That was no good. We needed to improve on that.
Pretty strong review there. Rebuke that. What's the new hot game? I saw the car stream today for a little bit, and then I had to go. So how do you do four thumbs up? You just grab someone else? Can you hold up two hands for me right now? Yay. I guess I gotta do one for one. Don't have to. Don't just do it for me. Do it for all the little guys.
Super job so far, we're getting great data. Stay focused.
Late break into that corner, and I don't like it at all. Just makes such a mess of that little complex. It didn't used to be there.
Great lap. You've nailed what
we asked
for.
It used to be this really long stretch into the front straightaway, but because it was so fast and we had some dangerous crashes, they got rid of it. Even though the other turn was really technical too, it just was only one corner. Double apex spin.
Super job so far.
Alright, now that we have a number for that. Tires are gonna wear pretty
so
hard.
So far, our fastest lap is race a 1 minute 21.0.
About 50-55. How are they going to make FIFA 21? I guess a lot of sports are Zoom. The right parts on the car. No, we have to change in between sessions though, because I think all of these parts have to be swapped. How do we do on time?
You're my hero.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Verstappen, Schumacher, and Valtteri Bottas. And that's it. Practice is officially over.
That's
amazing.
Until
next time, goodbye.
That can't possibly be a real time. How many laps did he do? Okay, that's like bullshit. That's bullshit. We have to put in... have to put in correct engine parts for the last practice. How can you get, is that like, isn't Drunk on Noodles, isn't that like a big samurai film thing? No, I just like, isn't Drunken Noodles a thing? Is that a like Chinese food thing? I did not know it says right here how many points you need to score to get the... Style noodle shopping. Yeah, what's his name? Jackie Chan knows the drunken style. One of the three styles featured in an arcade game, which whenever he plays, there is to be no blood. And when he beats you, he mocks you. I wonder if we could find who performed it. Are you secretly a black belt? I didn't know. For whatever discipline.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three.
Nick
who are
third.
Hamilton, Ricardo, and Mick Schumacher.
Our team is getting good. Team is getting too good. How did we not get that much? I guess we're level 14. I would think so. I know there's a bootleg title. That's something. Wow, are you serious? Did I learn something about you today? Pretty happy with this car, so we're just gonna hit it. I'm not gonna change the setup, I'm gonna resave the setup. The because of how quality works, we have to put in three laps, three sessions. According to the qualifying program, it said we might even get pole. We're actually good at this track, so... And our car has been upgraded since... Feels really good through that corner. I could almost accelerate even sooner. Get out of it alive. A second off Hamilton. Wow, they're really putting in good time. Make sure we have a real gearbox for the race. Oh, this is the last race on this gearbox. Got it. Six is about right, given what our car is. Mick actually makes it to round two. Could make it to round three. So this is the one that whatever tires we use is what we start the race on. We could try it on mediums first. We don't have any mediums available, so... Don't have any mediums available. We chose more softer tires. So, qualifying the only sets we have available on soft. We did not get that corner very well. We'll lose like half a second lap in this one. This is not that badly. When is Koya American Truck Sim the game? We gotta deliver the babies. Great. This is below Carlos Sainz. What is below our teammate? Might have to go out again. See, yeah, we're... Out another set of softs. Okay. Just What if there's a bot? A Death Stranding bot. Now we have a comparison to race against in this session. I really wish it would carry over your, like, a reference lap and show you, like, where you're at.
We have 2 laps of fuel remaining.
I got a medical ship forever. Dear. Right now we're trying to chase our way into Q3, which we may not get to. Can't get a good lap in it. I wish the game would show us what the current drop zone time is. Really just need to nail that one corner. Gotta nail this corner. This is the best, but it might get us there. Go around again. We have enough fuel tank to do it. No, we have to get more fuel. We might not have the pace in the car to do it. We might have actually increased the difficulty to the point that we can't do it. We're gonna get one more shot.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:18.7.
Last lap of the session for sure. Currently sitting 14. If we don't get in, means we can maybe start on the hard tire or something and try to get around people as they pit. Here we go. Gotta get 10th or better here. Which is probably a few tenths away. Now we have a worn gearbox, it's going to be great for the race. Well, that is one thing we can do. I really don't want to do it for this race because we have a really good shot at winning. I thought we did. Not with this lap. One thing we can do is if we're going to qualify this far back, we could just take the penalties. Get ourselves a new engine for later this season because our car is not reliable enough. We got a new talisman sometime. They used to go on sale. I think it's a talisman. Nothing. Got nothing for him. He's got nothing. So, if we're like 14. Hell, that's even worse. Really turned it up for that. That one session was magically faster than any other session that we've had. Really good way to gauge things. Our teammates at a 1:18. I do wonder if that's a really close session. The whole field covered by 1 second. So if we're 16th, we're taking new engine parts. It could be our gearbox is actually no good. If we take any part, we might as well take all the parts. Beat Albon's. We may very well lose the claims in this. Yep, we lost the claim. do the race here.
Tough luck there. It's not quite where we'd want to be on the grid, but chin up, it's not the end of the world.
Let's get a new gearbox. New gearbox. We're at it. New engine. New everything. That was the easiest goal ever. Yeah, some of our vehicle performance, I guess, is going to be amongst the best now. Gino's face? The guy from the game. Not supposed to rain.
The Spanish Grand Prix has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. The Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya then, a high-speed 2.89-mile circuit which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Schumacher, Sainz, Ocon, Norris, and Kimi Raikkonen, Kvyat, Ricciardo, Sergio Perez, and Gasly, Stroll, Lawrence. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Antonio Giovinazzi and George Russell, Magnussen, Albon, De Vries, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time.
219.
So let's head down to the track and get this.
That's gotta be a bug.
Underway.
219 grid penalties.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
They really want to start a median. Yeah. Okay. I can wait. I almost want to start at hards though. And what is pole position? The first spot on the grid. It's the pole. Twenty-two grid places. Alright, here we go. Here we go. Finally, we're racing in Catalonia. Everyone improves. Ready? Hey, exploded it. Just starting the race. We're starting at the back of the grid because we replaced the engine in the car and the gearbox. Okay. Okay, there's really nowhere to drive around any of you. It's way wide now.
Mind that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage.
Yeah, the AI doesn't really give you... I mean, the AI is pretty good in this game, but it doesn't really... We're at the back of the pack. Like, we're faster than a lot of these cars and ways to put this in, so we're not going to necessarily get out of our way. So we're going to be trying to make passes in bad locations just to get around them, so we should have a superior car. But penalty is wing damage. Like, here we could go really faster. We should just wait for DRS at this point. We got out of the dumpster. Like this corner, we should be able to outbrake. He really should have cut it across.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
That's bullshit. That was bullshit. Let's try that again. Let's see if I can convince them to not go inside. Okay, that was maybe better. We haven't had to race other cars like this in a while. But yeah, with certain things, the AI will shut the door on you, which, realistically, I mean, you really shouldn't be putting your nose there, but in the real world, you'd probably get away with it.
DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Albon is getting out of my way. Oh, see, he had to come over. We just cut him off. Where's that? Like, so for instance, this move that he made would be a penalty in real life. This is a penalty. To come back in is a penalty. So I guess we were supposed to leave him space there, I guess. I guess it would be nice. The wing is really messed up, so we're actually losing time every lap now. But considering our luck with safety cars in this, we'll get to a point in the race that'll be a safety car. But yeah, we have a little bit less downforce. It's noticeable. It's not a ton, but definitely understeer on the car now. What the leaders are going to do, though, because that soft tire doesn't go far enough. The soft tire is only going to go like 10 laps. Or are they just going to sit on the hard tire the rest of the race? Which would be awfully slow. Probably get George Russell here. End of this lap. Russell here coming in. this straight. Or just be really close. Just be really close, too. Slap. Safety car, let's go. Whoever that was. Taken care of now, hello. Well, we got a position. Not the one I thought.
Okay, clear. Yet.
Safety car. Box this lap.
Safety car, safety
car. Box
this
lap.
No overtaking, reduce your pace. Keep your delta number positive as we form up. Got that, confirmed?
Reason not to. So we're gonna go onto the hard tire here.
Nick is coming in for his stop.
I don't care. We're gonna be stacking the pit stops here. Are putting on a new wing. Her last car running, so it doesn't matter.
Release, release. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
Oh wow, we were on a ridge too. The good news is we just kind of get to drive a lap. So far behind the safety car field. So we can't finish 22nd, that's for sure, unless we get DQ'd. So we're going to try to take the hard tires to the finish. You can see that many of the other runners went to medium, so they're not going to last to the end of the race, though. Driver ahead.
Raikkonen ahead. Our gap to the car in front is 14.9 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. We think they've got one more stop.
Race should restart this lap? I think if race restarts this lap. Maybe next lap. We're still catching the queue though. So that pit stop. Alright, we've caught the leaders.
Pick up the pace a touch, please. We need to close to within 10 car lengths of the car ahead.
In the back, who cares? Do we have... We don't have another set of mediums. We have the same set of mediums that just came on.
Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap.
That entire start didn't matter for us, basically, because we had kind of had to make the stop regardless. It was our best shot of catching up to the field.
Hello.
Oh, stupid. It's limiting my... Here we go. We're going to still be in the chicane when I can say go. Okay, that's the game that did that. Restart again. So the game basically took... Right now, it's... For whatever reason, you aren't allowed to just have full control here. The game is controlling your throttle, and for some reason, it just decided to just kill me. Very strange. Alright.
Fuel is looking really good. You're managing it well.
We're gonna see who we can catch, and the answer may be no one. Might have to dial down the difficulty. Maybe we just need more upgrades. This car is understeery now, or oversteery all of a sudden. No DRS until the next lap.
Some information on Albon. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. Virtual safety car deployed.
Wow.
Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed.
This will only be for a few corners. DRS will be enabled basically right as soon as the race continues.
VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags.
DRS should be enabled pretty soon here. We can stay close going into the lap. That's our finish. Should have a shot at these guys.
Has been enabled.
So now we
DRS,
can get DRS
is now enabled.
The other thing is that these guys are on a better tire than we are. They're on fresh mediums that have about a second lap more pace than we do. The fact that we're holding with them is probably a good sign. It's just not going to help us get around anything. But we might be able to get up into the points later. It's just we're going to have to kind of wait for these tires to fall off of them. Get those lap times come down, and then when we get to these straights, we actually have a much better entry into them. Get them. See here, like, we should be... I don't understand how that was damage on my phone. I'm not accepting that. cars really lose a big quarter now.
We're trailing our teammate by 2.1 seconds.
That's good news, because he's in, like, the top. He's somewhere towards the front. Got a Ferrari in front of us, but I think it's because they had to pit. In fact, there's some of these cats that are actually going to pit. So we're actually going to benefit here, I think. That's our teammate, actually, five cars ahead. There's a position. There's a real position. Nicely done. That was a good one. Then we get DRS going into this corner. I don't understand why this is a DRS corner. And I understand why it is. It's just that you never get a good amount of front. It's kind of like the setup to get closer for this other section. Always a butt clench when you do that. These tires are just second to lap player car behind. Then again, we've been racing, like, what, six laps? It's like 2% a lap? Some of these cats' tires are starting to come down a little bit. How good they were. This really helps to have a car that's a lot more stable on exit than the last race. Right on these guys. So glad the car held for that. Alright, we can now actually see cars that are worth championship points. This has got to be in the top 10. These guys are all still on mediums. Oh, there's someone pitting. It's a leader pitting. Now I have a leader behind us. That's good news. It was Hamilton by really quickly. I don't know if these cars are going to make it though the rest of the race. Okay. Hell no. Get out of my way, dude. Was Hamilton. I do get DRS though. past my teammate again.
DRS is offline.
No.
The rear wing is down, so you can stay out.
Really? A DRS malfunction. That's great. Well, these guys are all pitting. Looks like we're gonna rejoin. They're rejoining this Ricardo. Are you kidding? That wasn't my wing, that was someone else's. He's losing more wing. Claire, what are you doing? You're throwing your race away. Okay. What is he doing? So another Formula One rule, when you have damage, like he does. You can get black flagged. He clearly doesn't have pace to turn, and then just kind of cut me off. That Raikkonen actually got a DQ for that, for driving around the broken front wing on the last lap of a race without immediately pitting. And he just finished the race with it, which you'd think, okay, normal rules, but I mean, like, he just was missing the front wing. And they DQ'd him anyways for being an unsafe car.
Fuel target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available.
I'm not trying to cheese things, but it's just like, how many times am I going to get clipped? We could just lower damage. Just accept the damage if we get it. Let's just let this continue through. They sure are slow in that corner. It's not how slow I think we should be. Okay. Now we can reset. Just as I blink. Keep in mind, Ricardo was one of the leaders. He's on hards now, too. That might be the problem, is he doesn't have the grip because he's on hards. I didn't realize that. I should have realized that. But he's good for the rest of the race, so if we have any hopes of winning the race, he's one to watch. Now, our DRS doesn't work because RNG. RNG has decided we don't have DRS. It never fails this much in real life. But the durability on our car sucks, so maybe that has something to do with it. Safety car in the BSC. Oh wow, we can actually cycle all the way up to the front of the race. I didn't realize that. They're driving like it. Ricardo just did the fastest lap of the race. So at some point, our DRS will get repaired. At some point. Vehicle condition.
No need to worry about tire condition for now. Everything's looking good. Okay, gap ahead is 2.0 seconds.
He's clearly got a faster car than us. We're not catching him, not without DRS. teammate's still in our rear, but he's going to have to pit. So our teammate is not finishing behind us. That probably won't be close. We still have the likes of Hamilton and those that were on the softs. They're going to start cycling up to the positions behind us. Some of these guys have to pit. Safety car really changed this race. We started last, and we could be finishing in the top three. Three thousandths of a second off of our best lap. We're still in the 122s. Remember, qualifying was in the 118s for us, the 117s for the pole sitter. Go. Our tires are probably going to be at about 50% wear towards the end of the race. That was a cool bounce. Brake bit hard doing it. Apparently not. I have busted a tire in this game hitting curves.
Gap to car in front is 4.1 seconds.
And we're not catching one. Did it again, way too tight on the corner. Too tight. See how bad this lap is because of that. He made pits before.
Nick is in the pits. Nick in the pits.
We got a new best lap. It was a legal lap too. Just start seeing a few laps that are faster.
Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tires.
Well aware, Jeff. I don't know where he's getting up catching the car.
The gap to the car ahead is 5.0 seconds.
I have no idea where he's getting up catching. I wish I knew what his last lap time was. That was just a spin. Wow, we gained some time there. We're stopping. Fastest lap of the race. Hamilton now behind. Or DRS works again. So we have the difficulty to expert level, so I'm not surprised that this has been a tough race. But man, we got absolutely wrecked qualifying. Now everyone's on this awful, awful, awful tire. If I've learned anything in this game is if you can avoid going on the hard tire, do so. Hard tire is just terrible. Looks like we gained about a tenth or two on Hamilton this lap, so our position might be safe, assuming our tires don't fall off to the point of oblivion. See how bad this lap was. And this is really the shot. I mean, can Hamilton get us on this straight?
We're leading our teammate by 26.5 seconds.
Getting him on a DRS range would be ideal. Kind of a half block. Full laps to go.
Our gap to the car in front is 5.8 seconds.
Everyone right enough the fastest laps in the race. We got Verstappen back over a second. I hope we're going to get Hamilton back over a second. He's got a much better car. Next race is at Monaco. Is that going to be great? Maybe Flashback City. Claustrophobic anachronism is what I call it. Fastest lap for us, but they're still on our tail. Our car needs some more upgrades, preferably tire wear. A long way to go in this race in 15 minutes.
We're at plus one lap of extra fuel. Fuel target, plus one.
Yeah, I'm very tempted to burn that fuel now. We might get these guys away from us. So if they get out of DRS range, we might be able to kind of shake them a little bit better. Carlos Sainz. He must be on softs or something. Should not have the car to be doing what he's doing. But if he's on a better tire, that would explain it.
No issues with tire wear for now. Keep taking care of them.
Doesn't help me, Jeff. Tell me where it's going to be at in 10 laps. Getting a little bit of headway here. Mm-hmm.
Rate gap ahead is 6.8 seconds.
Fastest lap for us, we're almost 121.2.
The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap.
No, he's not. He's not at all. He's still within a second. Period. I'm trying to put down faster laps to kind of get him outside that 1 second range so he doesn't have three DRS every lap. Sit on my butt. That the increased fuel mix is helping. Doesn't appear that we can really shake him. So he's not going to be able to get around us until we make a real mistake. Basically in like every racing game ever, so a lot of my comparison to how the car models feel and stuff comes onto this track. It also happens to be the test track for Formula One right now. One of their big testing out here in the winter test. And it has a good mix of different types of corners. That's not sort of why they like it so much. And the fact that it's somewhat central to the team.
Gap to car in front is 7.2 seconds.
How can we keep putting up fastest laps and still on the run? What I did learn is running in the rich mode actually heats up your engine pretty bad. If I get a moment, I'll show you the graphic that shows the engine temp, and it probably is going to show that it's yellow. I've been running in full rich for a while. There we go. See it? See the 129?
We advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2.
Oh, somebody actually hit that bollard. It's not us this time.
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Iron was still on the track. Not considered cutting the track. Now we're down to 5 laps to go. If we get third, it's really not that disappointing of a race, is it? A race that we started last. Got a little bit of help from the safety car yet again. Screwed by the safety car from the win before this season. For this season or the tail end of last season, we lost on the safety car. Botas got out in front of us. We both went in the pits. And then our pit crew took too long and I didn't do the pit stop perfectly. That lack of grip. There's just no grip. One thing you can't see is we've turned off pretty much all the assists. There's a small amount of traction control and anti-lock brakes. Since I really don't want to have to do dirt brake dancing, don't worry about brake setup. Lockups and all that kind of stuff. Used to race without it. It's just another thing to worry about on our entry and exit. If we had better tires, like this corner, we'd be gaining so much time on people. Just, there's just not enough in the car. Hardo passed his lap. We're still running 121. 3 laps to go.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Can't mess up the fuel in this game, because if you do, you're going to run out of fuel. Keep doing faster and faster sector 1s and 2s every lap. That sector 3 is killing us, and I think it's because the tires are really coming off. Yeah, these tires are bad. They're really bad. Good news is they'll make it to the end. Bad news is, I mean, that really explains why we're having issues, because that turn in on those last 2 turns is really bad. Okay, I understand more about what happened in this race.
We expect you'll be noticing a bit of grip loss in the tires around
now. Oh, really?
So just be careful.
Fastest lap of the race was just a 120. 127, and now it's the 126. We're in the 121.
Gap to teammate behind is 43.2.
Now our tires
seconds.
Are also way older than theirs. I know the game does simp a bit of that. You're not getting around me, Hamilton, is that right? You aren't running fastest laps. You must be running laps about where I'm at. That's probably why. enjoy the race and see what the we get back at the shop after this race. I think I have some stuff to do, so I don't think I have time to do another one. Also Monaco, so that'll give you some reason to stop by next time. Monaco is a lot of yachts, barriers. It's a street track. It's really famous, and it's really hard to drive. I can drive it somewhat okay. A little bit slow. We might also be turning down the difficulty for it, but maybe we won't. Maybe we won't, just to give these cats a shot in the season, because we're going to get to the other tracks in Europe. Let's see what we got for this lap.
This is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
Alright, Hamilton can't get it here. He's done. See, in Formula 1, what we just did there would be allowed. Our tires are so good.
Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty. The gap to the car ahead is 11.5 seconds.
Botas, this is domination of this race. Can use the Plunk Hamilton down the order. Remember Kurt Plunk? Some poor child had to make all the marbles small.
Job, he did really well. Super driving.
Safety car really helped us out.
Oh, baby. That was driving for me.
The Mercedes team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be
Mercedes,
proud.
Mercedes, Red Bull, Otis.
Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximize the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Valtteri Bottas passes his rival to take over the lead of the Driver's Championship. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Lawrence. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Racing Point this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
What do we got here? Can I link this to myself? Oh, I'm just saving them now. I just save the result. That was a pretty good finish. Oh, the fans really the interview that scares that. The crap out of Poya.
You're no longer in the top spot. Are you hoping to regain it?
I'm just keeping the season interesting.
You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy?
It's probably time to... Let's say nimble.
How do you feel this season is going for you? Is the car competitive?
Take a plane. So depending on what you answer, you get a small boost to various things. But it's not a very large boost. Wow, Albon didn't even... Oh, that's right, he crashed. I don't understand what how you don't get penalty free. Like, if you DNF, it's not a penalty, you just DNF. He didn't get a penalty. Look at Mick. Mick. Maybe that's why our acclaim is so low. It's because our second driver doesn't have a lot of points. What's the repair bill? Oh, we're not there yet. You did not hold first place for 4 laps. Possible. Yeah, I swear the damage deduction is maxed out at 50 grand. Because we replaced the wing, took some damage. There's that juicy 800. And Monaco was next. Oh, goodness. Take power team building. Take G-force training. Then I think we take the 30 resource points. Yeah, we want those. All right. And I think the questions that you answer in the interview decide what's available for some of this too. Maybe not. Maybe it's just luck. All right. One thing we do need to look at though is our R&D tree. We're going to get the powertrain upgrade, but we're not going to get the chassis improvements. That's really going to suck, because Monaco is really chassis-dependent. Okay, what else can we get with 2,000 points in upgrade stuff? Additional strikes. Just more downforce. The ultimate in your downforce. This one's going to finish, and then we'll have access to more engine power, which will probably help us quite a bit. It's probably a really big deal. We just took a new engine. That's DRS. Straight up drag reduction. We might as well just get to this final upgrade. This last rear deck. Look at how much that it improves for us. See, we have really good wing, and when we started the season, this whole career mode, we received like the largest upgrades to the arrow first. These require a lot of points. It scares me when we get to the end of the season. Crankshaft isn't going to be done until Monaco. It's done without a problem, so that's cool. Maybe we just go intercooler next. I think we can only do one at a time. Energy recovery system and fuel efficiency. Fuel efficiency would allow us to run less fuel, so that's useful. The ultimate upgrade in engine power? Like, these engine power upgrades are probably really important. Do we have any bonuses? We have a 7% modifier there. No modifier here. Yeah, what the heck? Let's get the engine upgrade. Can we get the fuel upgrade too? Sure. Alright. Alright, that's gonna do it for this game. Oh man, Monaco. I do enjoy Monaco. I just know we're gonna get trashed in the race. It's bad enough that we would like go ahead and take another engine. let's go way back. Let's go run a 2000 Ferrari, a 1998 Byron. Let's want to use the deluxe. Just to give you a taste. Oh wow, you actually can do the short circuit on Bahrain, that's pretty cool. Just to give you a taste. Uh-oh. You came at the right time, Dragor. Time for us to crash cars. Fashion. Do I have a setup? We have a setup. But I don't know if it's gonna work for this car. But let's oh god. It's raining? Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa. Yeah, this setup is not... Really? Why did it choose raining just because it could? How about that? How about we start with some hope? I think I have a wet setup for Monaco in 2018, but I don't have one for this mode. So what we're doing is we're doing just some fun laps on Monaco. I don't have time to do the whole Monaco race right now. And so the game actually the classic mode where we can go in old cars. So this is the 2000 Ferrari. Which is whoa. Oh really? How about we knock that up a bit? Now this is bad. Good thing damage doesn't count. The off throttle, we have to fix that. We can just go into one of the newer cars if we need to. I don't know why it's not connected to the board. This is bad. I have no idea why that's. Oh, that's right. This setup is for. Hold on. Let's have max downforce because we're in Monaco. I don't know what else you'd want. Sure. Bring this up to about 80 off throttle. Let's try that again. Time trial mode's kind of cool because it lets you kind of go for the ultimate fast lap. Whenever we played these games in the old days, before King hit the sim race, like you didn't really have a time trial mode. So like you would basically just get the best lap you could in the practice session, basically. But the track conditions wouldn't be consistent or anything. Yeah, of course the back is validated. Oh! This is a very front-heavy car. It's the casino hairpin. So the other reason we're spinning out so much is we've basically turned off traction control. But it's much lower, so if you get on the gas early, you will do that. It just kind of gets all squirrely. Now, I've not really driven the classic cars in this game much, but it's really very oversteering. Damage is off in time trial mode, by the way, so we can kind of bash it to our heart's content. How are you doing, Dragor? How did I get a leaderboard position? I cut the track. Some washing. See you later, Explodative. This car is really loose in the front. We need to tighten that up somehow. Actually, no, I'd fix it. I could just fix it. You know what? Let's just fix it. So, what do we got here? That's a problem. It's fine. Yes. Sure. There's ballast on this car. Okay, well, let's move some to the rear. That's interesting that there's ballast. I gotta remember that this is an older... So I didn't realize it for the classic mode, but classic mode has different car settings, of course, because... Yeah, so they're not allowed to adjust the ballast anymore on the car, so in this series game they took it out. Okay, it seems less squirrely at the front now. So what we basically did was kind of help with the car's weight transfer. Of course, we cut the track. Just try to get some more front end stability. You might just want to, since we already invalidated the lap. Okay, on throttle. We just max the lock. Maybe we just max this so bring this down. Just bring it down. I want to get, now that I've pulled out one of the classic cars, I kind of want to actually get the insurance lap. Because this is actually, we used to play, the game was called Formula One Challenge, 1998 to 2002. It actually had four different seasons worth of Formula One in it. Really cool game. Funny enough, in many of these tracks are exactly the same. He really, really wants to step out when I hit the gas. Hit it again. But we lock the dip on the rear wheels, but it's the front wheels that are doing it. Stepping out, but it is. It's stepping out. It's more of a car issue. This car is really, really, really oversteery. I do know another way to fix it. Do one more lap, see if this is good. I don't understand why we're getting leaderboard position when we invalidate a lap time. Maybe it's just telling me what I would have gotten. It's not putting it on the leaderboard. If you're still around, Dragger, how's Doom? I caught the Pepper episode. Funny is it's taken like 300 laps around this to make this even look somewhat decent. I've done more 300 laps at this place. I've been just in these modern games. I've done a whole career race weekend with your career team. In the old games, we did hundreds and hundreds of laps. Oh, cool! I got a ghost now. Sweet. Racing my Patrick Swayze out there. When you can't see it, we're basically past them.
It's actually a really cool fact that the so the corner that we just went through, we have that full lock. They actually have to customize a suspension piece because there's basically, you can see how the suspension is at the front of the car. They have to custom build a piece so that it doesn't like shred its way through the housing where the suspension parts go in, because it turns so, the radius is so large, it's larger than any other corner on the calendar. If they use the ones they normally would use, it would actually shed itself into the interior of the car and the, in the interior of the tire, it would actually shred the tire as well. I said we weren't going to drive Monaco, and then we did. I said I was going to fix the setup too, and I didn't. Fixing the setup right now would be basically decreasing the front wing by one or two turns. Monaco is a really fun track once you actually can get to the point that you can at least do laps in. You start to feel really fast, and it feels like you're driving a car through an aircraft hangar upside down. Oh, brakes didn't go. That's fine. I my foot slowed off the brake. And then there we caught the, I like that, like, pieces of the car come out. What we were gonna do was, turn the garage and fix the aero here. If we pull down the front wing a little bit, we should have a little bit more adherence to the road all the way. Might go. Stiffer rear suspension is going to be more oversteered. Okay. I go stiffer on this, it might make it better. So what we're trying to do is basically the rear of the car wants to come around when we're on power. What I'm trying to do is sort of limit the traction circle of what the car wants to do. By lowering the front wing, it causes the car to understeer more. So we did a little bit of that, and we changed the anti-roll bar, which hopefully means that the front suspension doesn't want to, the wheels don't want to just kind of do whatever, they're kind of more locked together. Nope, it's worse. Wow. Minion Masters update. Let's actually switch cars. Let's get in a better car. Zero completed laps. Oh, I guess none of those counted. Oh. How's Minion Masters? That's a game I'm afraid to get into. You tempted me, and no, man, this is my one bad habit I'm currently allowed. It fluctuates between this Factorino. So this is the new car. This is actually the Black Lives Matter Mercedes that they put into the game. Hey, look, the car that doesn't want to just completely come around. People that love to tune and do time trial stuff probably really enjoy the hell out of the classic mode. That's a whole different car to set up. Set up into the race. Look at how much faster we are just magically by changing cars. Here we go, here's the gut check. There we go, gut check solved. Baby, what a lap. That was a good lap. That was a legitimate lap. I was gonna say, what the hell was that artifact? But that was actually our ghost. Oh, got the wall. I try to take that corner of really bad apex. Oh, that's actually a ghost for us to beat. Actual race, he would have busted the tire, that would have been it. For some reason we weren't just DQ'd for that. But we're not beating our lap time anyways. Didn't hit the brakes at all, just dumb. Fun track though. Once you get a good rhythm going, this is a really fun track. Everyone I know hates it. We used to race back in the day in leagues. I was like the only one to look forward to this track because once I got decent enough when I was practiced, I mean, the way our league worked, I mean, we only had one car, there was no flashbacks or anything. So once you screwed up, that was pretty much it, and I was pretty consistent. I wasn't the fastest, but I was consistent, and these races were the full race distance of the Formula One race. So it's like 80 laps around here, and other tracks as well, and I would basically bring in a bag of points for our team every week because all half the field would just crash. Now they were racing for like the win-win, but like I was racing for top 10, like 80 people. Now sim racing has gotten so crazy, people are really good. They good. They look good. Always be better. I also pick a lot of different games that people don't. And unless you're playing this all the time, I have all the games, just like sometimes I can drive a different car. This lap, we got really good off that last turn. Oh, we're gonna hit the wall. Oh, we didn't get invalidated. We didn't beat Kansas City, whatever the hell he is. But we got our personal best lap. How do you like the closets? Just in the closet all the time. We're ahead of this guy. It's funny that we can bounce off the wall, but as soon as we touch the railing anywhere else, we lose. didn't get it validated there. Oh, we caught the curb. Caught the thing. We did a really, that final corner we did really well. Really shouldn't be ashamed of a 114 in Monaco. Hard track. There's a crosswalk there, that little hump in the road. I have actually been previous games, I actually crashed there, hitting the car, one of the front wheels squirrely. That's interesting that that's a cut. How is that a cut? Is it just because my wheel was off the ground? Must be how it's affecting it. I mean, it has to be using telemetry to figure that one out. Did we do another thing of dirt? Did we do some dirt? My best lap. Did we actually get one? Wow, you only needed a 119 to get the bonus? Custom setup, yes. Actually, that guy was using the default setup and crushed us. But our third sector was better. Was better than. It's a half a second faster. We had identical. We actually, if you look at the second and fourth lap, the first and fourth, we actually had an identical lap time. That's really crazy. I think I might be done. Just eat up some more food. Oh, Mario Marathon is back up. Oh man, I gotta play Sam and Max. Neon Abyss. Adam. Oh, Wonders. Well, I guess I'll go say hi to Pepper from the Quick Host. Still around, feel free to say hi. If not, have a good night.
So, like, every town is singing
They're
now?
Fake. They never lived. There's no one named Remus or Rock.